Hi guys, welcome to another episode. As you can see, I'm still working on the keyboard I've been working on in my episode number 2, where I show you how to repair the individual keys, because in this one a lot of the keys appear to be non-working, and the ones you can see soldered on here are now finally working. The ones missing are still not. What I did was I removed all the keys and also the metal cover, and I removed the IC because I wanted to clean the board completely. And what happened when I removed the IC was two of the pins broke off. Now this one, as you see, broke off completely. The other one I will show you in a second. Why did it break off? Not because I was not careful enough, because you need to be careful when removing the ICs. The problem was that these pins were oxidized and they just fell off basically when I took them out. The reason for that is the, well, not so smart placement of the IC unit directly under the space bar, because it's the key you use, well, I'd say the most. And over the years, a lot of sweat and probably other liquids slowly go into the keyboard, and that's the result of that. Now, how I'm trying to salvage this. So the other one, I'll show you that one first, did not break off completely, which is good, because that was an easy fix. I just used the wire, wrapped it around, you see. You have to be careful, because otherwise you're gonna break off the remaining part as well, and it's easier that way. And I actually tried it already. This works. You just need to be careful that the wire is not touching this pin next to it, because otherwise you're gonna shorten the IC and probably destroy it for good. Now on the other side, like I showed you before, we'll try to solve this with another piece of wire and a new socket. Why a new socket? Because when I will use this one, you would face the problem that it's inside there and it's hard to get there with the soldering iron, and it's hard to work in there. So we'll use a new socket for that. So what I'll do first is I am going to put the IC into the new socket, and as we have already one repaired pin here, I'll start with that side and be very careful, because we do not want to destroy the fix. It is socketed, and now we're going to fix the second part. And as I told you, I have a piece of wire. It's just a small wiring I broke off an old capacitor, and I will insert the wire into the socket and make sure it touches the remaining part of the pin. You can see it. It's that really teeny tiny metal plate sticking out. And we need to make sure that this wire is touching it. Now, before I'm going to fix it, I will just apply a little bit of solder to this piece of wire so that the solder is already on there. That's what we want. Because it's easier when it's already on the wire. No. Okay. Now I've messed up a bit, but we have this does not matter because this part we're gonna cut off anyway. But I have solder applied here. That's approximately the spot where it's going to touch the pin. And now I am going to stick this in. Now we have a little bit more metal touching the remaining part of the pin. And what I'll do now, and I hope this works, is I'm gonna just carefully heat up the solder, which we have applied already, and hope that it attaches itself to the remaining part of the pin. Because it's getting too hot, and I hope you can see this because it's a bit tricky. All right, it appears to be not moving, which is good, and I'm just going to cut off the remaining part of the wiring. Ah, all right, it's still moving. That did not work as it was intended. Okay, once more. As you see, it's a bit tricky. I'm actually shaking because I do not want to touch the IC with the soldering iron, but it's hard to make it stick without heating up the pin of the IC, so it's a very, very delicate process. Well, maybe try to apply some more. What I will do now is I'm gonna plug in my Mac and see if this works. Now, for testing purposes, I have put the socket, including the IC, into the socket existing in the keyboard. We cannot fix it for good like that because now the IC is above the cover, so it will interfere with the spacebar. There is just not enough space, but in order to try it, it's easier that way than soldering it on and then realizing that it's not working. And as you see, I'm running system 3.2, and I will start keycaps. And now let's just push any button, and it appears to be working, which is good. Which means the IC and the pin has contact and we can actually use it like that. Now the next step will be desoldering all these pins in order to get out the old socket and then solder on the new socket including the IC unit. I did spare you the soldering action. It's not as beautiful as before, and these old boards are really tricky because, as you see, a lot of the traces and solder joints, they break when you desolder them even without applying any force. This is what happened here to me. But what I'm using to salvage this is a conductive pen which you can draw on, and that really helps solving these issues. I have again booted the Mac. I'm opening keycaps and moment of truth. Yes, it is working perfect. So what we've done here, even though it doesn't look good or reliable or anything, but at least we saved this old IC, because like I mentioned, you cannot get them anymore because they use a type of programming that can't be copied. So you cannot just buy a new one and program it. Hope you liked this video. I hope it helps you solving your IC issues. And please subscribe to my channel and take a look at my other videos. Have a great day. Cheers.